his grandmother.
And my husband said there was guns. He heard the shots, but they didn't have to kill him like that. They didn't have to shoot him that many times. And the detectives that came in and kept telling me, don't go outside or go in the back. I said, well, what happened? I hope y'all didn't kill one of my grandkids, because they come to the back door. I mean, to the window.
Sir, shots fired, shots fired.
Copy, shots fired.
And he said, Grandma, I'll be 24 in August. My grandson was 23 years old. And then now my great-grandbabies don't have their daddy. Because they didn't even stop. Why did you just shoot him in the arm, shoot him in the leg, send a dog, send a taser? Why? Why y'all didn't have to do that?
God bless you. God bless you.
Black and brown people.
We have the solemn obligation in preparing for an independent autopsy to go view Stephon's body. No family should have to endure this pain and suffering as they try to seek answers for execution of their loved one who is only holding a cell phone, shot 20 times.
And in his very last speech, he said,
and we will work hand in hand with the local groups, all the way to the state groups and the federal groups, to ensure that this fight for justice does not die, because Stephon Clark's name must live. Yes. Live along with Michael Brown. Yes. Live along with Trayvon Martin. Live along with Alfred Alongo.
Right.
Live along with Oscar Grant.
Yes.
Live along with Eric Garner.
Yes.
His name will live.
Yes.
His name will live.
Yes.
His name will live.
Justice.
Justice. I want justice for my baby. I want justice for Stephon Clark. Please give us justice.
Justice.